What's up, everyone? Hey, it's Justin again, and I have an interesting review of this Columbia River Knife and Tool Guppy, which also came with this Eaton Tool thing here. I'm not sure how long I've had this. It's honestly been riding around in my car for probably 8 or 10 years, and I just recently took it out and put it in my knife case with my other pocket knives and multi-tools. I thought it might be, find some better use in there. So anyway, I just saw this kind of hanging out in there, and I thought it might be interesting to do a review on it. So, get that piece of whatever off there. So yeah, this is my review of this little guy, and just share some thoughts and kind of show you the features of it, and let's go ahead and get started. So blade steel on this does have a blade. It's up here in the top. I don't know what the blade steel is. Probably 8CR or something or other, or a lower variety of it. I am kind of making an assumption here, but I'm gonna say it's probably not a very high-end steel, especially at this price point for CRKT. So I give the blade steel a score of a 3. I'm sure it's fine. The edge on it is sharp enough, and I'm sure, it'd be fine for everyday carry and basic uses. The edge isn't gonna hold up forever. I'm sure the toughness isn't super high. The blade is coated, which is nice, so that'll help prevent any kind of rust. But I'm sure it's just a basic, relatively cheap stainless steel, so. Anyway, I gave it a score of a 3. Moving on to the clip. This does have a clip on it. As you can see here, retention's pretty good. I actually have never carried this in my pocket. I just put it in my pocket before the review, and the clip seemed to adhere the tool to my pocket, well enough. Has plenty of space there for jeans or thicker shorts. It does leave, quite a bit hanging out of your pocket, about that much. But the cool thing about this is, if you don't want to use the clip, it also has this little, carabiner here. The whole thing sort of serves as a carabiner, so that's kind of nice. So you have some options when it comes to carrying this. So I gave it a score of a 7. As I mentioned in previous videos, yeah, I call the category, clip, but I sort of evaluate however you might carry this knife or this tool or whatever it is. So, I think this one's pretty good, and that's why I gave it a score of a 7. Looking at the materials on this, they're nice enough. I believe this is stainless steel. It has developed a little bit of rust, but nothing too severe. This is like a plastic housing, and there's a little flashlight in here. That's probably why this is plastic. Not sure what kind. You can see a little spot of rust back there, but yeah, the materials are fine, nothing fancy, but stainless steel, non-stainless steel, and I'm not even sure what this is. This might be aluminum. It's pretty lightweight. So yeah, anyway, materials on this, I gave those a 6. And I actually skipped the lock type, which this knife does not lock. It just opens, and then it has sort of a, I'll just call it a spring that keeps it open. It's non-locking. It will close on your hand if you push hard enough, but it's held open well enough for comfortable use. So it is a non-locking knife. So we talked about materials. Size-wise, I'm gonna remove this tool here for a minute. So this is the guppy, and I'll just take the knife out, kind of set it like that. Get the Mannix going here, and then the Buck 110 below it. So you can see, pretty small. The blade's probably maybe 1¾ inches. So pretty small little blade. The tool overall is pretty small. It doesn't hardly even make up the entirety of the Buck 110 handle, but It is a pretty hefty tool, you know, considering all the steel. I'll close this up. And then you can see it is pretty thick. And you have this little bit set on the side here. And this is pretty thick here, just the handle itself. And I think some of that has to do with the fact that it's also a wrench. And it has this little carabiner feature. So, yeah. So there's the two components again. But thinking about the action on this, this is more of a slip joint knife. As I mentioned, it is non-locking, but it has a nice action to it. You know, it's stiffer at the end here to keep the blade held into the handle. It does get easier to move around this area. And then when you get toward the end of the rotation point, it does sort of seat into some type of detent right there. So, yeah. Action, pretty good on this. I'd put it a step above the... actually, I put it the same as the Swiss Army Classic, but I think I'm going to uprank that to a 7. The action's pretty good. It gives you confidence in using the blade. You're not going to be too nervous. I mean, again, you have to remember it's non-locking, but you know, it's a good enough action to give you the comfort you're going to need to use it when you need to use it. Moving on to the hardware. So the clip screws are T6. This pivot is a T10, and then you have a few little Phillips screws here. And here, this is kind of the cover. This is the cover for the flashlight battery. And then you have a Torx screw here. I believe that's a T6 for this carabiner lock. So, yeah, hardware is pretty good. I've never taken this apart, but I imagine it's probably not too difficult to do that. Cleaning, you know, also not too difficult. You pretty much have access to everything aside from, you know, inside this little wrench. I don't even know what to call it. It's like an adjustable wrench, but inside this area here, you wouldn't have a lot of area to clean if something got in there. But otherwise, yeah, it's gonna be easy to clean, easy to maintain. So I give it a score of a 7 for hardware. Moving on to price. This was, I don't even remember what I paid for this. Maybe around $40 at the time. 35, 40 bucks, which, you know, considering all you get, it is very reasonable. I mean, it's, you know, you get, I'll kind of go over the features here, but it came with this Eaton tool. So you have like a spork here on the end, bottle opener. You have some hex wrenches up here at the top. And then the guppy itself has the knife. Has this carabiner, has this little adjustable wrench on the end here, which is really neat. I've never seen that on any other multi-tool. And then it has all these hex bits, which, let's see if I can get one of these out of here. You can remove the hex bit and put it in the end so it becomes like a wrench. So that's kind of cool. I don't know if these go in from this side. It has the flashlight, which I did remove the battery so it wouldn't corrode it. And yeah, so it's overall really nice little package, good deal. So I did give it a score of an 8 for price. And then finally, quality. This does leave a little bit to be desired. It is, you know, overall well made. I mean, I did give it a score of a 7 for quality. It's fine. It's nothing spectacular. I mean, this tool is, you know, the edges aren't too sharp. I guess it does have a pry tool here. The edges aren't too sharp. You know, has nice etching on it. And then the blade, you know, as I said, the action is pretty good. Decent clip. This carabiner feels nice and sturdy. The wrench itself is, you know, there's a little bit of movement in there, but all the styles of wrenches I've handled that are like this have that similar style, you know, type of movement. It has these bits in here that are coated. Yeah, I mean, the flashlight, it worked all the way up until I took the battery out, and it had been riding around in my car, as I said, for probably 8 or 10 years. So you know, quality, it is good. It could be a little bit better. I mean, the spot rust and stuff, the places that the rust popped up, you know, it was a little bit surprising. It just tells me that it's not all stainless steel, but, you know, at the same time, it is only, you know, 30, 35, 40 bucks, whatever that may be. So, yeah, overall, just a nice little tool. I would recommend picking one of these up, maybe throwing it in your truck, throwing it in your car, just kind of having it as a backup. I mean, it includes all the features you would probably ever want. And I guess I didn't even point this out. It came with this little carabiner, too, attached to this Eaton tool. So, yeah, just a nice little option for you know, having a knife, having some bits, having a wrench, having this tool here. And yeah, I would definitely recommend this. So in total, let me add this score up. $45 in total for this guy. And I will be posting my updated scores on Instagram probably in the next day or so. So anyway, thanks a lot, guys, for watching. If you have any comments, please leave those below. And please subscribe if you haven't. And have a good rest of your day. We'll talk to you in the next one. See ya.